support this bill. And in doing so, I really don't think it matters, even if costs will be involved. Because we know that governments across the country, particularly states and federal governments, have been suffering from overpricing and so many other things when it comes to government purchases. And this is one institute that will give some powers, enhancement and capacity to our accountants in the various ministries, not only restricted to the corporate world, so that when they discharge their responsibilities, they will do so with full knowledge of what they are supposed to do. Corruption, as we know it, is not, as some people would like to believe, restricted to politicians. Accountants, particularly in the ministries, departments and agencies, have been causing havoc over the years, some deliberately, some due to lack of capacity. And I believe that this institute will arm such accountants so that when they do government business, they will do so especially in the area of costs. Because I've taken special note of measurement of performance against standards. And this is one area that the Auditor General, who has so many auditors under his control, will come into action and play. Mr. President, distinguished colleagues, I also want to add that we need to look at the corporate world when it comes to corruption. Because there are so many things that are happening there that I think government needs to take particular interest in. Because corruption anywhere is corruption everywhere. It doesn't matter whether it is in the corporate world. Once the laws are not followed, it means that government needs to show some interest. And I believe that if we have armed, trained, and capacitated accountants, this time trained by the institute, we have a better chance of dealing with corruption across the two divides of corporate world as well as government. This bill has been in this National Assembly for about 16 years or so. I think it has become an indigent. If there is anything we need to do, is to fast track the passage of this bill so that it doesn't get to the next session of the National Assembly from 2019. With this, Mr. President, I want to urge all my colleagues to support the passage of this bill. Thank you very much for the privilege.